Ben here, back out of the sawmill. Now, I don't have a thermostat out here to tell you how cold it is, but I do have one on my back porch. So before I got started today, I went out and took a look at the thermometer, and I'll show you about how cold it is out here. Now, the left side is Fahrenheit and the right side is Celsius, so everyone got a decent comparison on this. It's about 18 degrees, I'd say, Fahrenheit. About 8 below Celsius. Okay, now that you know that it is cold out here, you know, I just wanted to give you an idea exactly how cold it is. It's actually starting to snow, and, you know, come out here to get started this morning. The skid loader doesn't want to start up. You know, I got it plugged in, but it's still cold, so I decided that instead of using the skid loader, trying to warm it up just to move a couple logs and shut it back off, I'm just going to let the skid loader go, and I'm going to use my log arch to move some logs around here just to get something cut today. Now, a lot of people are fair weather cutters and they're not going to be into this running around out here in the freezing cold, but you know, last couple days it was Christmas, and a couple days after Christmas had some time with the family, so I didn't do much the last few days, but I'm back out here again now, and I want to get some more of these logs cut up. I'm going to keep cutting as long as I've got logs, so that's my plan. I'll just keep right on cutting right through winter. Let me show you what I've got going on here today. I've got this pile of ash logs I want to get cut up. I started already, I've got a couple of them. Here's my log arch. You can see the drag marks. I started dragging them before I even turned the camera on. Originally I wasn't even going to show this part, but I figured, you know what, I'll show you guys how I get it done here. So there's three logs there that I drug over already. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to hook this log arch. Is pretty simple. Just got a couple of handles here. My wife actually ordered this for me from last Christmas. So this was my Christmas gift last year for moving logs around. There comes a time when the skid loader is not going to be available, or, you know, it's either out of commission or it's off being used on other jobs. There's times I'm going to have to move logs by hand. These logs here aren't too bad. You know, I couldn't tell you how large of a log this thing can carry. I think it's up to a 26-inch log, I think, or a 22-inch log. But don't quote me on that. But I can tell you that I don't really want to haul anything larger than what I'm hauling here today. Now, these logs are roughly a foot in diameter, maybe a little bit more. I'm just going to haul a couple more over there. I've got three over there now. I'm probably going to take these next couple here just to show you. Get them stacked up over there, and then we'll see what cutting frozen ash logs is like. You know, ash is a very tough log to cut, and being cold out doesn't make it any better. So I'll drag these logs over to the sawmill and we'll get started. All there is to this is just a log arch here and a set of hooks. Now all I'm going to do is just pick this up, run it to about the middle of the log here, and just leave these hooks lay over the other side of the log. Come back, there's a set of handles up high, grab a hold of this, pick up on it, and generally that picks the log right on up. And I just pull this right along, make it look easy. This is a small log, but get the log about where I want it, let off on the handles, come over, take the hooks out of the side of it, set it down here. Got my cant hook here that I can roll these logs with, but if they're small enough I just move my foot. I should have had these up on another log to keep them off the ground a little bit, but I thought I was going to get to them a little bit faster than what I did. They're kind of frozen to the ground. I'm just going to take pick up on it. I gotta pull up off the ground a little bit. Get it pulled out away from the rest of the pile. Come back here about halfway. Knock that frozen stuff off of there before I put it up on the mill. This little log arch comes in handy. There's been a few places that I've had to use this to move logs on property that I couldn't get a skid loader on. If you get the logs down, you can haul them out to the road or out to the trailer, wherever I have to go with them. It makes it a lot easier to maneuver them. I hooked this up to a small tractor. Even a garden tractor would probably do it. Sure burns a lot less fuel doing this by hand, I can tell you that. And that about does it. That gives me 7 logs here. I can roll right up onto the mill and get cut. So that's enough for me to get started. If I need a few more, I'll go over and grab some more. But I think for right now, that'll do.